So I made a video on the recently held Pakistan elections, in which we talked about the challenges that the country is facing, such as economic crisis, political instability, and disputes with neighboring countries. We also discussed in that video how Pakistan's military is backing Nawaz Sharif, sidelining Imran Khan. Moreover, we predicted that either Nawaz Sharif or someone from his party would come to power after the elections, because of course, they have the support of the powerful Pakistani military. And we were right. With the military's blessings, Shehbaz Sharif, the younger brother of Nawaz Sharif, is now the Prime Minister of Pakistan for the second term. Many senior officials have openly accepted that the elections were heavily rigged. Many people are calling it the most rigged elections in Pakistan ever. Popular public support was with Imran Khan, and that continues. The stolen mandate has led to massive protests. Pakistan's military did everything it could to ensure that Nawaz Sharif's party wins the election, such as keeping Imran Khan away and stripping his party of its cricket bat symbol, etc. Despite the absence of a level playing field, Imran Khan's supporters performed much better than expected. But everybody knows that in Pakistan, it does not matter how popular you are, what your merit is, or how many numbers you possess in the National Assembly. If you want a stable government, the only thing that matters is the support of the Pakistani military. In Pakistan, no government to date has managed to complete its term of 5 years. Before the term ends, assassination, removal, dismissal, or a military coup, etc., throw the government out of power. But these are just methods to topple the government. The actual reason is that the military does not want that government to be in power. So until when can a government be in power in Pakistan? The simple answer to this question is, until the government remains in the good books of the military. It sounds bizarre, but that is the reality in Pakistan. Pakistan is one of those countries where in reality, the political head is not elected by the people, but is selected by the military. The so-called elections that happen in the country are just a formality. At times, when the military is not in the mood for even this formality, then they directly go for the military rule. Talking about the present-day scenario, as usual, the country is actually being governed by the military. Shehbaz Sharif is just the face selected by the military to appear to govern the country. Why Shehbaz Sharif? Because he would have been the best alternative in the eyes of the military. Of course, the military cannot let Imran Khan come back to power. And the track record shows that compared to Nawaz Sharif, Shehbaz Sharif is relatively more obedient. Thus, the military might have felt that he would be a better puppet who would interfere less and not challenge the military's power. He would also be more dependent on the military. Looking at the economic and security situation of Pakistan, Shehbaz Sharif will require military support to quote-unquote administer people. Presently, Pakistan is reeling with protests, widespread agitations, rising anger in the public, and increasing public support and trust in Imran Khan. In a situation like this, the government will need military support to crush dissent. The more the government's dependence on the military, the greater the power of the military. New dramas unfolding regularly are common in Pakistan. Things remain interesting year-round, and we hear about a lot of unpredictable events. Pakistan has a different ballgame altogether. Still, experts predict that next year could be quite interesting. Mr. Asim Munir took charge from Mr. Bajwa at the end of the year 2022. Call him the incumbent head of the military or the incumbent head of the country, it is one and the same thing. Anyway, the term length of the Chief of the Army Staff of Pakistan is 3 years. This term length can be extended with the Prime Minister's approval. Before Mr. Asim Munir, Mr. Bajwa enjoyed 2 terms. Well, he had a lot of work which could not be completed in 3 years, so he needed 3 more. There is a saying, you scratch my back and I will scratch yours. It basically means a give and take relationship, a kind of reciprocal arrangement where mutual favors are exchanged. This came to my mind suddenly because Mr. Asim Munir's term is ending at the end of 2025. So it will be interesting to see whether he will get an extension or not. Also, it will be interesting to see whether Shehbaz Sharif remains in power until then to approve his extension. Look, we wouldn't be able to know exactly what happened. We can only guess based on how things pan out. So let us wait and watch which way the camel sits.